Yeah, you can pull it out of there if you want to, but yeah.
Okay, can I, and then?
Oh, good. I'm just gonna be walking up.
Perfect.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Okay, thank you. I've been in COVID for a while, and for those visitors here, just to let you know a little bit about Normandale practice, when I say hello, I expect
hello.
Yes, there we go. This is awesome. And for those of you watching, I see folks online. This is a wonderful opportunity, and we're really grateful for the folks who are here. Before I get started, I would be remiss, and always we have to acknowledge some of our legislators, and we have some of the best legislators around, and Representative Elkins, thank you so much for being here. Our legislators really support us, just like all the other legislators for our other institutions, but we're really proud of our legislators who pick up my call when I reach out to call them or our staff, and they want to get to know our students and want to help our students. I'm not going to take the thunder. I have a lot of folks who are going to come, and I don't want you to hear the same thing over and over again. But I really wanted to thank Lena Men for being here with us today and for acknowledging the work that we're doing here at Normandale. Normandale has been on this journey for a while now, and actually, as I was looking up some dates, come next year, it'll be 10 years that we will have had a cupboard of some kind. And it's so exciting to think about it. I was talking to my mom this morning, and I said, no, really think about it. It's as if the old cupboard was about the size of maybe your bedroom. Okay, now this new one is like, yeah, it's bigger than your whole apartment, right? And so, I mean, which is just an amazing thing, and particularly for Normandale Community College to be the largest community college in the state, I think that it is important for us to be leading, you know, this work, and we're so very happy for it. And we also want to thank our colleagues in our foundation, because we know we can't do this work without the philanthropy that exists. But it's not just the monetary philanthropy that we really love, but it's also the time that people put into the work. And so one of the stories I love telling is over the beginning of our pandemic, students weren't coming to campus because we were closed. And some of our staff, particularly our staff from AFSCME, so if AFSCME, you're listening, way to go to you all, but all of our staff were out there and delivering the food to the students at their homes, right? Which was an amazing thing. And so again, I want to thank our Normandale community for being a part of this work. And I'm going to stop there. So thank you so much. And Daniel, our student senate representative, will be here. Come on up. Woo.
Oftentimes don't think about the people who live in Bloomington, Minnesota, or within the Twin Cities community in general, because that's just not what many of us picture at first. That's a very narrow piece of the pie when it comes to like food insecurity, thinking about the different organizations like that. It's commonly known fact that college is expensive and difficult to navigate financially, and the pandemic has obviously brought on some extreme challenges to the campus cupboard, along with support services in general, many of which this has increased the demand for basic needs services, which are oftentimes not met by the community just because of the large scope that's necessary. And to showcase this point, it was often found that over a third of Normandale student body on a yearly basis was typically food insecure, with that being defined as having limited or uncertain availability of sufficient foods and nutritious foods. This is exactly what the campus cupboard was created to solve and why it is a very important part of Normandale Community College and our local community. Along with the cupboard, Normandale has many resource centers, such as the Veterans Resource Center and the Student Resource Center, which address needs that are specific. Things like transportation, childcare, healthcare, different things of that that are just necessary for people to be able to get by, especially if they may not have access to those resources outside of community college just due to being very busy with work and other commitments. These have proven to be a very practical and necessary asset to Marmaduke for these reasons. These initiatives are a very good value to Marmaduke Community College and by association our local community. So thank you to Lee and Min for this honor.
Coordinator here, and I coordinate our campus cover and our food shelf at Normandale. So as you just heard from Daniel, you know, sometimes I get the question, less so now, but kind of like, why does a campus care about hunger? Like, why does the campus have a food shelf? Why is that part of your job? People are often really surprised. And, you know, I have many answers to that, but part of the reason is, you know, as Daniel mentioned, we know that statistically, and this was really pre-COVID, about a third of our students are food insecure, and that would self-identify as that. And so we know those numbers are probably even higher. And, you know, so for some of us, it's about hunger. And I really like to always, wherever possible, you know, go to what our students are telling us. So on surveys that I've gotten from our students that have used our campus cover, yeah, some of them say, you know, one quote from a student was, it helped me put food on the table on days I had nothing to eat. Obviously, you know, hungry people cannot learn. We know that. And so beyond just that physical need of hunger, as other speakers have mentioned, we know that food insecurity is broader than that. You know, part of it is that stress, the psychological concern of saying, where is my food coming from? How am I going to get, you know, how am I going to get through this week, this month? And so for, you know, some of our students, one student quote was, it acted as a buffer against worry that I may not be able to meet all of my physiological needs. And so through things like having these resources, having our food shelf, you know, we're hoping that we can make that better for students. Just last week, I had a student that came and he said, thank you so much for this. This is so key because I'm able to focus on school instead of, you know, the stress I used to have just knowing every week, where am I going to get my food? And so I take a lot of pride in that we can take the edge off for students. Obviously, we also know that it's, you know, it helps our students, retain our students, helps support their academic success. Another quote from a student was, you know, the safety it provided me helped me concentrate on class. So, you know, that is why we care about being a hunger-free campus. And also, you know, again, many reasons, but I'll also touch on, you know, I think it's really rooted in doing racial equity and food justice. I think as we know with Minnesota State that we are charged with becoming a more equitable, racially equitable institution. And, we know that Minnesotans of color, even before COVID, had about 2 times the rate of food insecurity as, you know, our other Minnesotans. And so I think we have a responsibility there. I have many, many things. I could talk forever about that. I'll try to keep them very short. But obviously, thank you, Lita, and for this honor and the work that you've done in the Hunger-Free Campus space. I think it's really essential. And, you know, thank you to our administration, President Esther, to our amazing partners. We have, you know, Hope for the Community, Dr. Al Garacki is with us here today. We could not, you know, be doing what we're doing around food insecurity without these amazing partnerships from our amazing alum. Thank you. You know, Facilities Foundation, Advancement, all of these things, and our Student Senate. And, of course, to our students who guide this work. You know, if our students were not brave enough, willing to step up and say, you know, here are my needs, here's what I'm needing, we wouldn't be able to accomplish what we do. So thank you, everyone. Appreciate it. And that's to Aria from our Student Resource Center.
Our on-campus resources are invaluable. It is this wide variety incredibly pleased with the work that Normandale has done and will continue to do as we work towards being a hunger-free campus. You know, we've been doing this for a really long time, and I really hope we'll get another 10 years out of it. I anticipate it, frankly. I do think, truly, a hunger-free campus is a campus where students feel valued and safe. And I hope that that message, you know, continues on as we continue our work. You know, we at Normandale really take pride in our student basic needs work. You know, they are just that, basic needs. We don't think anyone should have to worry about where the next meal is coming from, or if they need rent assistance, or if they don't know how they're gonna come to campus. It is so fundamental for not only success, but to just thrive in life as we know it. That's why I'd like to thank Dr. Esther for creating a campus community that is just, sincere, and inspired. It's Dr. Esther's vision that has allowed us to make this progress and to make Normandale a shining example of how student needs should be acknowledged and factored into every single decision we make, whether it's in terms of student services, academics, or even just saying hi to students on campus and being able to sit down and talk with them. I'll try to keep this short and sweet, so I'd like to thank Axel, the DMN president, for coming here today and for also just really helping us and acknowledging the work that we're doing. I'll conclude by thanking the person who is the true champion for Campus Covered, Paige Wheeler. You know, Paige has really brought Dr. Esther's vision to life, and she continually works to expand and improve the resources we can offer. So, I'm just completely honored to work alongside her. Thank you.
Well, hi everyone. Thanks for joining us today. You know, this is my first time visiting Normandale. It is a rare pleasure in general to get to visit campuses these days, but I have to say, Normandale in the statewide student leadership community comes with a certain reputation for the passion and achievement of its student leaders, and also, frankly, your guys' size. I was saying before, Normandale is the Texas of the Minnesota State Community and Technical College. Everything is bigger here, including your food shelf and the robustness of your resources, which is a great thing. So I'd especially like to thank President Esther and Vice President Georgiev for letting us join them in celebrating this outstanding achievement. And I'd like to thank Representative Elkins for being here and him and the state legislature for supporting the Hunger Free Campus Act and putting funding towards it this past spring, which was really awesome to see. And furthermore, I want to thank all the leaders Normandale has had and continues to have on this issue, be they students, staff, faculty, administrators, who have passionately worked towards ending food insecurity for the student community. I think Normandale really exemplifies that it takes the work of a full community to make real change on an issue like this. It takes the full commitment of everyone, because an issue like food insecurity does not exist in a vacuum or does not just affect the individuals that suffer it. It affects the entire community. The goal of the Hunger Free Campus designation is pretty straightforward, I'd say. It's a clear set of action steps to fight the scourge of food insecurity. By establishing a food shelf, a team to ensure it lasts, and regular programming to destigmatize using these resources, a college can both meet the immediate physical need of food insecurity, tend to the wider impact it has on students, and maybe most importantly, permanently shift its campus culture to one of caring, where students not only intellectually know, but truly feel that they matter and that their whole humanity matters, not just their work in the classroom. Normandale has been an incredible leader on this issue. I mean, you guys have had a food shelf for almost 10 years. That's long before this was part of the mainstream conversation of higher education. Being at the forefront of this work has led to your work benefiting, I'm sure, thousands of students, and your commitment to the cause of a Hunger Free Campus is true. Students go to college with a shared dream, all of us, the dream of a better life, of the opportunity and fulfillment a degree can open the door to. And that dream can be stalled or destroyed by struggles like food insecurity. Most of those challenges have been exacerbated by the pandemic. And at this momentous time for the future of so many students, places like this determined that no student should go hungry. With the passionate service of student leaders and the whole campus community, and this hardest time to be a student leader, I'd like to give a special shout out to Armadale Student Senate for that. Your college is an example of what students everywhere need and deserve. You guys are a blazing torch that has been an example and the way forward on this issue for nearly a decade, and I have every confidence you will continue to be. So for all your hard work and outstanding achievement and determination to support students, I am proud to present Normandale College with the Hunger Free Campus Award.
So they weren't even thinking about what they needed. It was something that they wanted for their sibling at home. And now the ability, and I'm gonna take a line from our wonderful donor. What he said to me today was that our cupboard is not just transactional, it's transformational, because it's not just helping that one student, it's helping that family, it's helping that community. And so I'm gonna use that, and I'm also gonna use everything's bigger at Normandale, so we are the Texans. So if my colleagues in Minnesota State get mad at me, I'm blaming you, I'm just saying. But I love it, and I really think that it has a heart, and we all have to do this work together, and I'm so grateful for that, and for our faculty and our staff and our community who donated to the center, and also to Campus Compact for our VISTA volunteer that we've had for the last several years. We've been really excited. At times we didn't think we'd have one, so I'll also thank Campus Compact as well. So again, I also want to thank our legislators for supporting the initiative of Hunger Free and all the work that we're doing here. I'm not going to belabor this any longer, but also I would encourage anyone who might be watching us, you know, we will still take donations, right? That's okay. And also for our students, and as I think Paige mentioned, we know that one-third number is for those students who self-identify, but there's also a lot of students who haven't identified. And so for those students who are sitting at home, maybe listening to this, come on down, it's here for you. And so we want to know, what I always say to students is that asking for help is not a bad thing. That's what we're here for, right? And so please make sure we can help you. Please make sure that you come and seek us out. But again, to Lena and Men, thank you so much for this. And to our Normandale community, thank you for it. We're done.